How to get the ball more as a striker in soccer. That's what we're going to be covering today. That's coming up next. Really quick, guys, before we get started, I would like to thank the sponsor of this video, OneFootball, which you can download for free down below in the description. OneFootball is an incredible app for all football fans that want to keep up to date on the latest results internationally and at club level, keep up with your favorite club, your favorite national team. They also even have video compilations of different things, which I think is actually really cool, one of my favorite features on this app. Again, this app is absolutely free, and it's just a must for any football fanatic that wants to make sure they know what's going on in the world of football. So make sure you give some love to OneFootball by downloading it for free down below in the description. Without further ado, let's get into the rest of the video. Also, before we get into the first one, guys, because we're covering strikers and forwards in this video, if you haven't already, get my free product, Strikers Secrets, and this is going to give you a bunch of videos that are going to help you to improve in this position. It's absolutely free down below in the description. So without further ado, let's get into the first way you can start getting the ball more in this position. So the first one is very simple, and make sure you are checking to the ball. Now, there's many different movements you can make as a striker to receive the ball or encourage your teammates to play it to you. And one of the simplest is to push off your man or find that space and check to the ball so that you can receive it. Now, a lot of times you're gonna need to play the ball off right away or shield it, but other times there might be defenders who back off, which give you the chance to turn and make something happen or do something similar. But in many situations in the game, especially if you're being marked, you wanna be able to push off your man, get away from them, check to the ball quickly, and you may again have to play one or two touch from there, but sometimes other options will open up. But this is one of the easiest ways to quickly get available for the ball, just doing that little check off the player and coming to the ball. Next is channel runs. Now, what does this mean? This is something that takes a little bit of work rate from a striker, and it usually is used to relieve pressure. Sometimes it can happen on the counterattack, but it is when one of your players will very quickly kind of curl the ball down the sideline to the channel, and you're making that corner run. Now, a lot of times in this situation, you're gonna have to get the ball and shield it, cut it back in order to play the ball to some of your teammates that have now come into the attack. So this is one where you're doing definitely a service for your team, being that outlet for them, but it's something you need to be aware of. Look for when your team needs to relieve pressure or there's a counter on, and you can spin into that channel, get your body there first before the defender, and make something happen or bring your teammates into the play. It's such a common run, and it's one you really need to know as a striker, and one that's very frustrating if a striker doesn't make. Just ask your defenders or midfielders when they're trying to relieve pressure, they'll sometimes blindly play it down that way, expecting the striker to know to make the run. So make sure you are looking to make that run, especially when your team needs to relieve pressure or there's a counter on or you just see an opening to do so. Okay, the next one is one of the fun ones because this is one that will get you in on goal, and it's penetrating runs. Now, there's many different ways in order to do this. Sometimes you'll just be on the shoulder of the defender, you'll lock eyes with your player, and you'll burst into that space, make that run, stay onside, and be in behind. Other times you might need to curl your run and dash somewhere. Other times you might need to kind of fake out the defender, but ultimately you need to be making these penetrating runs in behind, time your run to get in on goal. Again, you need to be making these runs not only because you'll get the ball and have chances to score if your teammate is in sync with you and makes it happen, but also it's going to put the defenders on edge. If you're kind of buzzing around, always making these dangerous runs, you can make a defender very nervous when your movement is really good. But look to get in behind, because as a striker, when the ball is in certain positions on the pitch, that's what you want to be trying to do. Again, there will be times when you need to run into the channel, when you need to check back and do some of the other things that we're going to go over in this video. But that penetrating run, you know, that's going to be one of the main things you get good at that's going to get you those goals, make you a dangerous player. And when you can time that run, know which one to make in the right moment, It's just going to advance your game as a forward player, as a striker, that much more. Piggybacking off that last one, let's go over another one that's not only gonna get you the ball, but also help you score goals, and it's finding space in the box. Again, you don't have to be buzzing around like crazy in the box. If you watch some of the best strikers, a lot of times they're jogging, letting their man follow them, letting themselves be marked, and then boom, they make that dash to the near post, or they make that dash kind of coming from towards the goal, out to the goal to get that shot off right away. You wanna be looking for these types of runs, especially when your wide players have it, they're coming into the box. Because again, you're a striker, all goals count. You know, look to get tap-ins, look to get those easy goals where you just need to get good contact on the ball to score. Again, if you're just standing there and you're being marked out of the game, especially in these dangerous moments, that's gonna be not only frustrating to your team, but it's gonna prevent you from standing out in this position. Look to make those quick bursts in the box when it's out wide or there's a chance for you to get that first time shot off. It's just gonna make you a better player. Your teammates are gonna see you making those runs and play the ball into those spaces, into those areas more often. But again, don't take away these chances that can be the easier chances. Learn how to create just that second of separation from your marker, just getting a toe ahead of them sometimes so that you can poke it, you know, get good contact on it and put it in the net. So look to make these runs, especially in those attacking areas when the ball's coming into the box, there's that opportunity to put it across. Look for that ball right across the face of goal that you can tap in. You know, again, so many times you'll see the ball, you know, even in professional matches, you'll see it go across the area and no one took the gamble to make that run, that bursting run, that opportunistic run where they would have had a tap in if they did. So look to make this one. Again, it's not only gonna get you the ball, but it's gonna get you goals. Next one, guys, is to hold the ball up. Now, I don't care if you're a target man or not. Now, a target man is just someone who looks to do this a little more often and is usually better at it. But as a striker, you need to learn how to get the ball with a man on your back, hold it up, and then play it to a teammate or do what you're going to do. Even to sometimes learn how to spin that man if he's too tight so you can get your shot off so you can do something else. But you need to know how to hold the ball up. A lot of strikers shy away from this. They don't want the contact or they're a little scared to do this, but it is necessary to learn how to do this. And again, if you can do this confidently, guess what's going to happen? Your teammates will feed you the ball more and more. I mean, if you can be a player like, you know, Giroud, he would be so good at this. It was like, if you ping the ball into him, he's gonna keep it. He's gonna bring it down. He's got great control, great strength to hold off his man. And that just brings other players into the play. And, you know, it makes it one of those outlets that teammates will look to when they need it, right? So they'll look to that person they can play the ball into. It's gonna stick. Harry Kane's the same. If you watch him, he will get the ball with a man on his back a lot. But because he's so good at keeping the ball in those situations, he'll get the ball more and more in those situations. So make sure you're good at hold up play. It is an important part of your game. Not the only part, but it is an important part, and you will get the ball more if you can demonstrate some ability with this. Now guys, I mentioned this in other videos about not losing the ball or how to get the ball more, and it's exactly that. Don't lose the ball. If you're constantly calling for it, making these runs, but most of the time you lose it, you turn over possession, you do something silly with it, well, your teammates are gonna automatically look at that and go, every time we play to Dave, he loses the ball. You want it to be like, oh, every time we play to Dave, he holds it up, he does the selfless work. Like, he's not always selfish. Sure, he's a striker, he's gonna be selfish sometimes. I'm gonna take a shot, I'm gonna, you know, do whatever, and that's fine. But watch a player like Harry Kane. Like, he does a lot of the grunt work that helps his team. Again, the channel runs, a lot of times is gonna be grunt work. You're gonna have that man on you immediately, you know, and he's gonna be on your back, and you're gonna be doing a lot of running, but it's a great outlet and can lead to a good attack from your team. The hold up play can be like that, the checking sometimes can be like that, but these are the things you need to do. And if you can prove to do these things well, your team is going to just start unconsciously giving you the ball more, because they'll notice when you get the ball, good things happen. So make sure you're not losing the ball all the time when you're getting it. It'll happen sometimes. You know, sometimes you'll be trying to hold it up and you might take a slightly bad touch, or you go make the channel run and you're not able to hold it up, or whatever it is. That's gonna happen. But aim to not lose the ball. You know, aim to at least try and make something happen. And when you get good at these things, it will encourage your team to give it to you more, because they'll want to give it to the players that keep it and make things happen. All right, guys, so those are just some ideas on how to get the ball more as a striker. If you implement every single one of these things, you will start getting it more. This will improve your overall game as a striker. A striker's game a lot of times is knowing where to be, the runs to make, how to be dangerous. So make sure you are doing this. And if you are doing these things, I gave you a lot of different types of runs and movement you can use to get the ball more. If you're doing those kind of things and you're in more openings to get the ball, you'll end up getting the ball more. It really is that simple. Also, one thing I can throw in there is make sure you do call for it, be vocal. I didn't have that on the list, but obviously that's important. I guess I think that's self-explanatory, but just in case you forget that, call for the ball. All right, guys, so that's gonna be it for this video. Again, get Striker's Secrets down below if you haven't already. It's absolutely free, and I will see you in the next video.